Well, would you look at that? Kara was supposed to be the last on my revenge list. I wanted her to witness all her loved ones suffering. But as it turns out, she'll be heading to the heavens first. Or maybe to hell. I just knew that insane woman would be useful to me. Thanks for that, Lucille.
How will we find the strength?
Mother, I know this isn't easy for you. But I promise you, and especially Kara, this won't be for nothing.
Please tell me they found her.
I'm telling you, she's gone for good. She fell to her death back at the church. Go check. They're holding a funeral for her now. As tempted as I am to give you my sympathy, as a person should, I just can't do it. Actually, what I would rather do is to congratulate you. Lucille, good job. Keep it up. If only you were still here, I would have wanted you to suffer some more. But that's how it is. What's done is done. When it's time to go, then it's your time to go. In any case, you were the biggest obstacle to all my plans anyway. You're gone now, and that makes it easier to take my son back.
It's so painful every time I have to look at the coffin. Never in my wildest dreams did I think I would be burying my child. It's a parent's worst nightmare.
Becca!
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 What's happening to you, sweetie?
What should we do, Ethan?
Becca!
Becca!
The plan is working. She will not be able to resist. Mommy's obsessed at the thought of being with me, so she's going to make it happen.
I'm just relieved because I don't know what I'd do if something happened to you. I would lose my mind, or I would go crazy, or maybe it would kill me, too.
Sada, we are one and the same. You are with me, and I am with you.
I love you very much. You're my twin, and I can't live without
you. Whatever it is our children are going through, I know that all we need is love, and it will be all right.
The Intrepid operation is a great success. My team just caught one of Alex's hired men.
I'm going there right now.
Be careful, okay?
Hello, Itoy.
Hello? Kara, oh my dearest. I'm sorry to bother you right now. I know you're doing something important, but it's about Becca this time.
Why, Itoy? What happened to Becca?
She passed out earlier. We rushed her here at the hospital.
Hospital?
Take him to the car and then to the precinct.
You good for nothing, jerk!
Sarah!
You sabotaged our event before, you crazy man! Where's Alex? Tell us where your boss is!
Sarah, stop it! Wait, calm down!
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know that Alex.
Oh, go to hell, you filthy criminal! You murderer! Just ran out
your
boss!
Wait. Sarah, just let me handle this man. I'll make sure that he tells me everything, okay? So we will know Alex's whereabouts.
Don't let him escape! You just tell us where your boss is!
Take him in!
You animal, you speak right now!
Sarah, that's enough!
No, Bogart!
Ma'am Alex, here's Mr. Hansen's last payment. The payment is complete.
Good. Yes, Gabo.
Ma'am, we have a big problem. The police have caught Bogart.
What? I thought there were no cops around there.
Entrapment operation. That's what it is. We were fooled.
That can't be! You mean to say you failed to take my son back? You imbeciles!
I'm really sorry, ma'am. What do we do now? What do we do with Bogart?
Just kill him.
What?
I said just kill Bogart. I'm sure that the police will do everything they can to track me down and finally arrest me.
So before that happens,
you must kill Bogart.
It's a good thing you anticipated Alex's next move.
I've been on this case for quite some time, so I already know the way that Alex thinks. Kara's wake is a good opportunity for her to get her son.
She's clever, so she sent one of her men to do it.
I will make sure that he tells me everything. I'll force him at the precinct later.
Okay, Chief. We're coming with you.
Yes, how is it? Have you arrived at the precinct? What? Just how did that happen? Okay, I'm going there now.
Chief, what's the problem?
We're going directly to the morgue now.
The morgue? But why? What happened?
Alex's henchman is dead now.
But how did that happen? Wasn't he with the police?
They're ambushed, and they didn't even reach the precinct.
I'm sure that Alex had him ambushed, because she's afraid that he might tell on her tonight, so she had him killed.
Alex is really dangerous now. Nobody is safe, even her own allies. We need to be careful about our plans.
Itoy?
Kara, Sam, thank goodness you're here now.
How's Becca? Where is she?
I was giving her medicine. We were praying when she suddenly collapsed. My goodness.
Mr. and Mrs. Acosta?
Oh, it's the doctor.
Doctor, how's Becca doing now? And why did she collapse?
I just got the result from the blood test. I'm sorry, but the chemotherapy didn't work. It didn't kill much of the cancer cells as we expected it would. It's become more aggressive now.
Wait, hold on. So what now, doctor? What are we supposed to do?
I suggest we go to the second line of treatment. We'll use more potent medicines on your daughter.
Stronger medicines? If we give her those medicines, will she be cured for sure?
The side effects will be hard for her to tolerate, but she really has to bear everything, because we have to perform the bone marrow transplant on her as soon as possible.
Doctor, please do what you can for Becca.
Ma'am, it's all done now.
Like you should. Come back right now.
Okay, ma'am.
What on earth are you looking at? Do you all want to be like Bogart? Tom.
Ma'am?
Keep a close watch on the Acostas. Right. I need you to find out where they're keeping my child. Don't you fail on this. Because if you screw this up, you'll follow Bogart to the afterlife. You get me?
Yes, ma'am.
Alex? What's happening? Why are you yelling at your men?
The police made a fool out of me. Because of their tricks, I lost a loyal man. Curse it.
I'm not surprised at all. Maybe you did something predictable again.
You know, you should just shut up instead. This is your fault, Lucille. Where did you come from anyway?
From Kara.
Did you really go to Kara's funeral? For real? Did you even go near her coffin?
And why would I do such a thing? Kara wasn't in the coffin to start with.
What do you mean? Wait, hold on. What are you talking about? How come she wasn't in the coffin?
Alex, Kara is alive. My daughter is alive.
What? Adolfo!
Ma'am?
Just what is she talking about?
I really don't know, ma'am. She was just suddenly shouting in the car. She told me that she saw Kara. She told me to follow her, but I didn't see anything.
Can you just shut your mouth now? My daughter is alive. She can't be dead, Alex, because we'll be a family again together with
Antonio. You're crazy! Kara isn't alive anymore. Just accept the fact that she's already dead. Stop with that nonsense!
No, Alex. Kara is alive. My daughter is alive. I saw her with my eyes. Alex, please, can you help me with this? Please?
I'm not going to help you. I won't support you with that insanity of yours. Go to her by yourself. I don't care about you.
Mommy, Daddy, what happened?
You passed out, sweetheart.
I'm sorry for making you worry again. I know you already have a lot of problems right now, and I'm being a burden.
Becca, don't ever say that. Of course, you're more important to us, sweetheart.
I know that, Daddy. I just don't want the both of you to worry about me. What I want now is for you to do whatever you have to do to fix our family and be happy. Because it hurts me whenever I see the both of you sad and suffering. Daddy? Mommy? Can you please stop crying now? I'll get better, I promise. I'm a very strong girl. Look at me now.
Oh no, sweetie. You don't have to, no need. We already know that, so you don't have to prove anything to us, okay?
But whatever happens to me, I will be strong for you. I just need you to be strong for me. Don't ever give up because of our problems.
Yes, sweetheart, we'll do that. Your mommy and I will be strong for you. And you, You just hang in there, okay? Just bear it a little longer.
I'll fight and I'll fight. And I'll keep winning.
We will promise that to you, sweetie. But you have to make a promise to us as well, okay? That you'll overcome your illness and you'll be strong. And you won't give up, okay? You can't leave us either. You just can't.
I won't ever leave you, Mommy.
I saw it with my own eyes. I'm sure that Kara is still alive. I'm not being crazy. But Alex doesn't want to believe me. So what should I do now? I really need her help now.
Alex is not on your side, Lucille. If she doesn't want to believe you, let her be. You don't need her. You can fix our family by yourself. I trust that you can do it.
Adolfo, here's the record of Bogart's loan transactions in the casino. According to Mem, you'll take his place from now on.
I feel bad for Bogart. Mem, Alex is a heartless woman. Do you really think he'd actually squeal to the police?
I have no idea. Why don't you just do your job and stop with the questions? If Mem Alex hears you, you'll be dead.
Do you think it's too late to back out?
It's not that easy. You know, I feel like we're a ticking time bomb in here. One wrong move, and we are dead. Finish that already. I'm really hungry. Come on, let's have dinner first.
Doctor earlier. Her condition's getting worse.
Getting worse? Isn't she undergoing chemotherapy?
Yes, but the procedure didn't work at all.
But she will soon recover, won't she?
I don't know, Sada. I'm really scared now. If you'd only seen her earlier, she was weak and suffering. But then, she was trying to be positive. And yet I feel bad for my daughter. What if we lose her?
Kara, don't you dare even think about that. Don't think like that. Becca is fighting back. We should fight for her as well, right?
I don't know what to do anymore. I don't know what else I can do. What if Becca leaves us? What if we lose her? I don't know what to do anymore.
Kara, you won't ever lose Becca. Nobody is leaving. Have you forgotten? You were cured with the same illness before. And Becca will too. She's fighting. Kara, just have faith in her.
What do you think you're doing? Are you stealing from Matt Alex?
Well, what if I tell you that I am? Are you going to tell her?
Matt Alex is my boss.
I know that. And I also know that you're very loyal to her. I have a question, though. Where will your loyalty to her take you? You know what? I just heard the rumor about one of your companions here. Oh, no. He was very loyal to Alex, am I right? But what happened to him? You know, Alex is one heartless witch. How about you? Are you sure you really want to work for her?
I can't do anything about it. She's still Sir Julio's wife.
Well, you can do something. You can work for me. I'll take my daughter back. So I'm going to need your help to do it. I can assure you that you're safe with me. You see, I can never kill anybody. So, are you in?
Now that Becca's here, are we still pushing through with our plans until burial?
Becca isn't well yet, okay? We can't back down at this point. And also, we won't be at peace just yet, while Alex and Lucille are still around.
Mr. Acosta, good thing you're still here.
Yes, why, Doctor?
It's about the bone marrow transplant for Becca. I suggest we start testing for possible donors right away.
Doc,
We've long been ready to donate.
Well, I'm going to prepare everything that we need. I just hope that one of you will be a match for Becca. Because for sure, we'll have a hard time finding a donor outside of your family. And as we know, time is very crucial for all of us. If we don't do the procedure very soon, I'm afraid Becca's body will deteriorate fast.
We understand.
Let me see that. No, no, add some more. Hurry up, please. Yes, that's enough. That's great. See? Didn't I tell you that I'm not like her? Here, this is for you. Take it.
Nurse? Nurse, we're all here.
All right. Just say,
Through the cheek swab and blood test, we'll know who Becca's match is and who her possible bone marrow donor will be. Whoever the donor is going to be, we need to prepare him or her and Becca for the bone marrow transplant. They should both remain physically healthy and free from any sickness. And after ensuring these, only then can we proceed with the operation.
Please press this, sir, for 5 to 10 minutes.
Ma'am, I really can't find your son.
But how is that possible? Don't they go home after staying at the wake?
They do, ma'am. Thing is, there are cops everywhere. I can't follow them.
So you mean to say there are police guarding the kids too?
Ma'am, not even once did I see the children at the wake.
What?
I think they're hiding the kids somewhere, ma'am.
Lucille, are you going to Kara's burial right now?
Why are they going to bury her? I told you Kara is alive. I'm going to see her later.
Adolfo, you and Jeff go with Lucille at Kara's burial. I'm pretty sure the children will be there. You've got to follow them.
Remember not to hurt my granddaughter, or you will answer to me. She's sick and in need of recovery, and she needs to be treated.
Eagle to Sparrow, what's the situation there?
Sir, negative, sir.
Eagle to Maya, update me.
Negative, sir.
What's up, Chief? Is she here now?
Not yet, but all our men out there are ready now.
Officer, we better start now, because they might notice us.
The car's coming your way, sir.
Whatever happens, I will always keep you in my heart, my darling.
How's it going?
Ma'am, the children
are not here at the funeral.
What do you mean? They're burying Kara without even letting the children see her?
I'm not really sure.
No, they can't pull a fast one on me.
Where's Lucille?
She's here in the car.
Ask her what hospital Becca is in.
And go to her right away.
Thank you.
you guys okay? I think we can leave now. The car is parked over there. Come on, let's go.
You're really beautiful, Mommy.
We look very much alike. Me, you, and your mama.
When I grow up, Mommy, will I look very much like you?
No, you'll be prettier than me. Sweetie, you're going to get better. You'll get out of here. You're going to go back to school. And you'll celebrate your birthday. And you'll graduate, too. It's going to happen. You still have a long life ahead of you.
It's really painful now, Mommy. I really want to be strong, but it's really difficult.
Becca, you promised us, didn't you? You promised us you'd endure the pain. You can do it, dear. If it's too painful for you, you just have to call Mommy, and I'll hold your hand just like this, and I'll sing for you. Just don't ever give up, please.
I won't give up, Mommy. Not ever.
Excuse me, miss?
Yes?
I'm the nurse of Becca Acosta.
Acosta? You're in the wrong place. She's not confined here.
So where is she?
She's been released a long time ago. She's just an outpatient in here. I thought you were her nurse. Why didn't you know?
Oh, because I was just assigned here. Well, this is my first day. They told me to come here for her.
Just call them about it.
Too bad I can't.
But why?
No load credits. Do you know when Becca will be back here?
I don't know, but you can ask Dr. Uy. She's Becca's doctor. They go to her regularly. Although, she's not around now. You can come back tomorrow.
Really? Thank you, miss.
Excuse me, sir.
We're here now. Becca, we bought lots of food. Take a look.
Here. Becca? What's happening to you?
Becca? Are you okay?
I'm fine, Mom. Don't worry. I'll get well, right?
Good morning, ma'am. Are
yes?
you Dr. Uy?
Yes. Can I help you with something, sir?
I just want to ask you a question. I'm just looking for...
Just hold on, please. Hello, Mrs. Acosta? Oh. It's okay. Oh, no. No problem. All right, hang on. I'll be on my way. What was that...
Hello, ma'am. I'm on my way to Becca. I'm going to message you where she is.
Very good. Just wait for Gabor there.
Copy, ma'am.
Excuse me. Where are you going?
Sir, blood test. I need to get a blood sample.
Oh, is that so? Go ahead, then. Perfect timing. I need to go to the toilet.
Don't worry, you'll get well, okay?
Excuse me, sir.
What is it?
I'm here to extract blood.
Blood test?
Yes, sir.
But you got a sample before.
Well, doctor's order, sir. You can ask her yourself if you want.
He's going to extract blood from you. Go ahead. Your Uncle Andy is here.
Mrs. Acosta, I'm sorry to have kept you waiting. What happened?
Well, it's Becca, Doc. She felt dizzy earlier. She's having frequent headaches, and I'm starting to get really worried about her.
Those are post-symptoms of leukemia. It's possible that these are happening right now because the first round of chemo didn't work.
Oh, what are you doing?
Hey, why are you
doing?
Asking too many questions?
Uncle Andy?
Shh. Uncle Just Andy? Shut your mouth. Shh. I said be quiet.
Doc, what are we going to do?
I'm going to check on her later and do some tests. It's possible this could be happening because of the spread of leukemic cells in her system. If that's the case, I have to reevaluate the right treatment for her. Then we have to expedite the processing of the bone marrow transplant.
Becca? Oh, she's sleeping again.
Yes, so be quiet, okay? Go away. Leave her to me.
But where are you taking her?
To the doctor for a checkup.
The doctor's clinic is that way.
Just stop meddling, kid.
Becca, wake up, Becca!
I told you to stay out of this.
Becca, wake up! You have to wake up, Becca! 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 Becca, please wake up! Let her go! Get your hands off her, mister! Mister, let her go! Mister, let her go! Please help us! Please let her go!
Hey! Come on, hurry, hurry!
Let her go!
Hey! What are you doing? Stop!
Hannah?
I couldn't do anything. He said he'd extract blood, but he didn't.
Andy?
Kara?
What happened here?
Kara, Becca has been kidnapped.
Ma'am, I'm afraid even Hannah was taken by the kidnappers.
Wait, what?
Please don't leave us! Let us go! Please don't leave us! Let me go!
What's your problem? You're so loud!
Aunt Alex?
Yes, it's me. One more noise from you, and I'll cover your mouth to really shut you up.
Chief, please, please find my daughters. Especially Becca, the poor girl is sick.
Mrs. Acosta, my men and I are on our way there. We're going to act on this as fast as we can.
Yes, please, do it right away, my poor daughters. What is it, sir? Have you found something in the surveillance?
Ma'am, we're on it right now. It'll be ready when the police arrive.
Okay, please give them the footage once they arrive so we can look for my daughters. And please, do it right away.
Aunt Alex, please let us go. I beg you. My sister needs to go to the hospital. Please, Aunt.
Get your hands off me. She needs to go to the hospital? Well, I don't really care about her. If she dies right now, then so be it. That's fate. Well, she's one of the reasons why my life has turned out to be this miserable.
Kara, I'm sorry I wasn't able to save both of them. Sorry I couldn't stop that man. I'm really sorry. Please accept my apologies.
Don't blame yourself, Andy. It's not your fault. I know and I'm sure that you did your best to protect my daughters. If someone is to blame for this, it's me. Because I wasn't by their side. They were kidnapped while I was gone. I couldn't do anything. I just hope nothing bad happens to them. Oh, Lord, my little girl.
And you. Why didn't you report me to your parents, huh? Because of you, I was imprisoned.
Aunt, I'm sorry.
Your apology won't do you any good now.
Aunt, I'm sure they're worried about us. We need to go back to our house right away. Or at least Becca has to go back.
No! You can never leave this place, do you understand me? I'm not giving you back to your family until they give me my only son back.
Kara.
Seb. The girls, they're gone. Alex was able to kidnap them. I just left them for a while.
She's gone too far.
Alex really has no conscience. She even got the children involved.
I'm really scared now. Something might happen to Becca. Mother, my daughter is very ill. She might get weak in there. I don't know what to do. My God.
Kara, take a seat first.
But I still have to decide first if I'll send the both of you back to your home dead or alive. Look at Becca, huh? Guess she won't be able to come out of this alive.
Aunt, you're a bad person! You're a bad person! Bad! Aunt, your face is scary! You look like a witch! A witch!
Witch? Oh, really? So what do you want? Transform you into little frogs? Huh?
I don't want that!
What?
Aunt, no, please!
Please don't!
Aunt,
them to their room. Hurry, get them out of here. Shut your mouth!
Aureliano is still finding out all the information from the CCTV and from the witnesses.
We have to find them really soon, especially Becca. Our daughter is sick, Seb.
Andy! Can't you really recognize the nurse? Please think it through again!
I remember his face, but everything happened so fast. If I see him again, I'll recognize him surely.
Oh my goodness!
Hello?
Hi, Seb. How are you?
Alex. Alex, where are the children?
Hey, Alex. Give the children back to us. You can face me instead. Don't involve them in this.
Is that Sarah?
Hi, Sarah. How are you doing?
Don't you dare hurt the children, you witch. If you do, I assure you that I myself am going to bring you to hell.
Wow, that's
too scary, Sarah. I advise you to be careful with what you're saying, okay? You wouldn't want to anger me all the more. Otherwise, I might send the children to the afterlife to have a touching reunion with Kara.
Alex, please. Please don't do this. Don't get the children involved. They have nothing to do with this.
Oh, they have.
Of course they're deeply involved here. Because they're one of the reasons why I'm suffering like this.
Look, Alex, if you want to take revenge, please don't do it on our children. Look, I'm the one at fault. I'll do everything you want. Just tell me.
It's too late for that, Seb. Because you mean nothing to me now, okay? And I have longed erased you from my life.
Alex. Alex, please forgive me now. I know that I have a lot of shortcomings as your brother.
Yes, you're right.
I should never have abandoned you before.
Alex, it's not
too late. I was really wrong. I was your only family left.
But I still abandoned you.
I regret everything that I did to you. Alex, please forgive me.
I hope that you can find it in your heart to forgive me.
My heart? I no longer have a heart. We can't bring the past back since you're the reason why my life got ruined. You crushed all of my dreams! You even destroyed my family!
No, Alex, no. You're just saying that.
I know you're still my sister.
You're still the Alex I used to know, who loves me very dearly.
What happened before...
Let's forget about all of it.
Why now, Seb? Can you bring Julio back to life?
Alex...
How about this? I'm going to give you an easier option.
Return JR to me at once.
In exchange, I'll give you the kids back.
And then what, huh? You're going to raise your son to be a rabid monster just like you?
If you want to see these children alive and well, you'll do as I say.
Tomorrow, wait for my call. I'm going to tell you where to meet. We're going to exchange our kids.
And you, Sarah, since you're being so brave at anything...
I want you to bring JR to me.
Just make sure that he'll be safe.
You'd better be sure you don't inform the police or anybody else. Because if you do that...
I'm sure you already know what I'm capable of doing to these children.
Alex! Alex!
Honey, you shouldn't have done that to Aunt Alex. She's going to be angrier. Becca, she shouldn't have done this to us, especially to you. Don't worry about me, Hannah. I'm still doing fine. Becca, you're not okay. We have to bring you to the hospital. You need to be treated right now.
Hey, Ma'am Alex ordered both of you to eat.
Mister, please have mercy on us. My sister needs to go back to the hospital. She must go there now. Help us. Mister, please. Mister.
I feel so bad for this little boy.
I know. I understand how you're feeling about him.
But I can't give him back to her. I don't want him to grow up in the messed up world Alex is living in right now.
But what about your daughters then? Especially Becca, she needs to be treated right away.
I know that, Sara. That's why I really don't know what to do at this point.
There's only one thing we have to do, Kara. Let's give JR back to Alex. That way we'll be with Becca and Hannah again. Even now, we have no idea what evil things Alex is doing to them.
Becca, eat this fried chicken. It'll help you be strong again. Okay, but let's share it. No, Becca, you need it more than I do. Don't worry, Hannah. I'm very strong.
You see, even if we give JR back, Alex won't stop taking revenge on all of us.
We know her so well. There's no assurance that she'll return my daughters to me either. I don't want to involve this child in those troubles. We have to find another way to get my children back without giving baby JR in exchange. Alex is rotten to the core. I don't want him to be involved. I'm ready to do anything, even give my life for my children, if not for baby JR.
We need to get out of here, Becca. You need to get treatment now so you can be strong again. I still want to spend time with you, Becca. I know that sometimes I get bad. I want to change that now. I want to show you that I love you so much, Becca. I love you so much too, Hannah. I loved you then and I love you more now.
This phone already has the detecting device that will help us to locate Alex. You just have to make sure that you and her talk for at least 5 minutes, so we can determine her exact location.
Okay, sir.
Man, are you ready?
Yes, sir. We're on standby right now.
It isn't Alex. It's Becca's doctor. Hello, doctor.
Hello, Mrs. Acosta.
I'm so sorry to call you at this time.
I know your family's going through a difficulty, but there's something you must know right now.
It's okay, doctor. Just please tell me what it is.
I now have the result of the bone marrow test.
And apparently...
there's a match from your family.
Really, doctor?
Yes. It's your twin sister, Sarah.
It's Sarah.
What?
Yes, she's the best match.
She's the only person who can save your daughter from her illness from now on.
So if you please...
just make sure that Sarah's always safe.
I'm glad that these little pests have gone to sleep at last. How nice do they look? Let me take a picture of them. Let's see if they don't get jittery once they see how their children look like right now. I'm sure they'll be desperate to return JR to me.
That Sarah was found fit to be Becca's donor. At least now we don't have to find anybody else.
But we still have to find Becca right away. It's good that we finally have a way to save Becca from her illness, but I still feel scared. I'm afraid that she might not survive in the hands of Alex. I don't know what to do. My goodness, why is this happening to us? I'm at the center of Alex's fury. Why doesn't she hurt me instead of them? Not our children, please. If she wants to kill me, I'll let her do it just so our children
Kata,
will be safe from her.
Don't you ever say that. Kata, I won't ever let Alex hurt you. We need not sacrifice any more lives just because of Alex. Arellano, this could be Alex. An unknown number.
Go ahead, sir. Answer it. We're ready to track her. Be sure to prolong your talk.
Okay, sir.
Hey, what are you doing, Seb? Go ahead, answer it.
Go on, answer it.
Hello?
Hello, my dear brother.
So, have you thought about what you're going to do this time?
Yes.
Yes, meaning you're going to give JR back to me?
You just have to promise us that Becca and Hannah are safe.
All right, but only if my son is safe, too.
Just tell me right now where they are and...
you'll just have to wait for it. I'm going to call you before 7, tomorrow morning. I won't risk it.
I just want to talk to my daughters. I want to make sure that the children are really safe.
They're doing fine. Actually, they're sleeping tight right now. I don't want to disturb them.
But Alex...
I have an idea. I'm going to send you some pictures instead. Bye.
Alex?
Gabo, Rudel?
Yes, ma'am.
Look for a computer shop that is very far away from here and send them the pictures from there.
Okay.
Don't make any mistake, okay? I don't want them to be ahead of us.
Have you traced her location?
Sir, we only went as far as detecting that she's in Malabon. But since the call was cut off, we failed to detect the exact location of the call, sir. But we'll keep trying.
So, are they still guarding Kara's grave now?
Yes, ma'am. The security's very tight. Ma'am, we might be wasting our time here.
Well, no. We're not leaving this place until I get to be near my daughter's grave, okay? I'm not leaving until I get my daughter back.
Really? Make sure that is verified, then get back to me.
Have you received any information about Alex?
About Alex, none yet. It's about Lucille. They think they saw her at the cemetery.
Oh, at the cemetery?
Is that for real this time? If you're sure about it, let's go and let's get her now.
My men are double-checking the info.
If it's really Mommy out there, I'm sure she doesn't know that I'm still alive.
Regardless if the information's confirmed or not, we have to go there. If it's confirmed, then this game is over now. And we'll find out from Lucille where Alex is hiding.
No, it's not that easy, Sara. I know my mommy. I've thought of a way.
What is it?
I've thought of a way to make her tell me where Alex is hiding. I know she won't ever hurt me, because Mommy loves me very much until now.
Even so, Kara, I won't allow you to risk your life like this.
Yes, Seb is right. Let me do it. I'll pretend that I'm Kara to Lucille. She'll believe me. I'll deceive her until she tells me where Alex is hiding, and after that it's over. They'll all be caught.
Sara, no. I can't let you do that. I'm sorry, but you're the only one who can be Becca's bone marrow donor. We have to keep you safe from any harm. What if Mommy gets mad when she discovers you're just pretending to be me?
None of you are going to make a move. Let's allow the police to find a way first.
Sir? Yes, sir. Men, back to base.
Hello?
Ma'am, the police are leaving now.
You sure about that?
Yes, ma'am.
The guards are about to leave.
Okay. Just wait for me there.
Okay, got it. Just be careful, okay?
Sara, I'm sorry I fell asleep. Did Alex call again?
Alex? She didn't.
Oh, where's Kara? Sara? Where is Kara?
Well, about that.
She went through with her plan?
Seb, I no longer tried to stop her. She has a point. That's the only way to end all of these troubles. One more thing, you don't have to worry. Because the chief is protecting her. We'll constantly communicate. We'll talk all the time.
I can't believe this.
Hey.
Arellano, where are you?
Kara, my child. Please forgive your mommy. Please forgive me for everything that I've done to you. I never dreamed of putting you in any danger. I loved you, Kara, more than my very own life. Please forgive me, Kara. Forgive me, my daughter.
Ma'am Lucille, let's go. Someone might catch us here.
No. I am never leaving this place. I'm staying here. I'm not leaving my daughter's side. I won't ever leave her. We have to get Kara.
Come again?
We must get Kara's body. Help me do it now. Let's get my daughter right now. What are you standing there for? Help me dig her body!
Ma'am...
I'm getting my child's body! I'm getting my daughter back. Nobody should be able to see you. Just stay here. Kara! Kara! Wait for me! Mommy's here!
Mommy, you don't have to do that anymore. I'm here in the flesh.
Seb, enough. Just let the police handle this.
Sarah, I can't sit around doing nothing, knowing that my wife's life is in grave danger.
Mr. Acosta, there's no need for you to go there. Your wife is closely protected.
How can I be sure of that?
We can assure you that she'll be fine in there. There are enough police there, and Sir Aurelian is also keeping a close watch there around the area.
Look, my wife's life is in danger. You can't stop me right now. I'm going to go to her.
Seb. What's that? What is that? How dare that woman? She'd better get ready because she'll get what she deserves. Don't! No, put your gun down! She's my daughter, she's Kara! Kara?
It's really me, Mommy.
I knew you were alive. I was right. My gut feel was correct. You're alive, dear. You can't be dead, Kara. I was right.
You want us to be together, right? All right, then I agree to it. I'm coming with you, Mommy.
Really?
Of course. I think this is the only way to end all of these troubles we're having.
Kara! 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 You don't know how much you... How you made me so happy right now. I've waited for this for a long time. I've waited so long to hear that from you. Honestly, Kara, when I lost you before, I was so devastated.
But, Mommy, remember, we also have to find Alex soon.
Alex? Kara, I tell you, we don't need Alex. We don't need her with us.
Mommy, no, we still have to send Alex to prison. Because I'm sure she's trying to ruin us both. Do you want her to try to separate us again? If not, then we have to send Alex to prison to put an end to those troubles. Mommy, you want to be with me forever, don't you? So we have to send Alex to prison now.
I'll tell you now. But my dear, you have to come with me. We must leave this place once and for all. Come on, come with me now. Hurry!